In the Buddha's time, there were 30 young men of Sawati who came to listen to the Buddha's teachings. The young men were so taken by the beauty of the Buddha's teachings that they all requested ordination. The Buddha allowed for them to ordain and gave them topics for contemplation. One of the friends, known as Elder Thisa, was a weak and irresolute man. He was a slave to the pleasures of taste and the senses. The Elder Thisa accompanied his friends for a while, then thought, "What is the benefit of me going? I will have to live in a forest, sleep with difficulty, live off scraps of food? No way! I will turn back." He then turned back. They survived by going for alms in the mornings. The other monks continued on into the forest and dedicated themselves to contemplating the topics given to them by the Buddha. They would use their wisdom to explore the truth of the Dhamma concept by using nature as an external example for contemplation. Then, they would turn the Dhamma concept inwards and use their personal experiences as an internal example for contemplation. When their minds were convinced of the truth of the Dhamma, both inwards and outwards, their wisdom was ripe, and they attained enlightenment as arahants. After the rains retreat, or Vasa, the monks traveled back to inform the Buddha of their attainments. The Buddha praised them for their diligence and achievements, and allowed them to reside in the forest where they previously stayed. After hearing the Buddha praise his monk brothers, the Elder Thisa felt left out and behind. He became intensely determined to catch up and make up for lost time. He followed his monk brothers to the forest, and he pushed himself to do intense meditation. Eventually, he fell asleep in a standing position and fell down and broke his leg. The monks then had to bring the Elder Thisa back to the Chetavana temple and brought him before the Buddha. The Buddha then asked why they had returned so soon after leaving, and they told him. The Buddha then said, "This is not the first time that this monk's procrastination has delayed you." Upon their request, the Buddha then told this story of the past. A long time ago, when the Bodhisattva was born as a famous teacher, he was the leader of 500 Brahmin pupils. He instructed his pupils to go out and gather firewood. The students quickly went about it. One of the students, who was lazy and prone to procrastination, searched for the easiest and quickest way to get his job done, with the least amount of effort. He found a tree that seemed to be dead and dried, and thought, "I can just take a nap, and when I wake up, it will only take a few minutes for me to quickly climb up the tree and collect some firewood." The young man then found some dried logs and took a nap. He overslept, and when his friends had finished and were on the way back, they kicked him to wake him up. He quickly climbed up the dry tree. In his hurry, and since he was still drowsy from his nap, a branch poked him in the eye. In his haste, he gathered some green wood that was still alive. Since he was late to return, he simply put his pile on top of the others. The master told his students to get a good night's sleep, and in the morning, they were to prepare food. Once the sun came up, they were all to travel a long distance and join a feast. Early the next morning, the maid grabbed the green bundle of sticks from the top of the pile and went to light the fire. Since the wood was still wet and not dried like it was assumed to be, the fire would not start. When the master was informed, he said, "You should all learn from the fool who tore down green branches. When you put off tasks and procrastinate, you leave yourself with less time to do your job. Therefore, the quality of the job suffers. And you will in turn also suffer from your diminished output. Not only that, you will also cause other people suffering, delays, and problems due to your actions. Procrastination is harmful to the person doing it and to the people around them. We will all now have to forgo the feast and stay home due to the actions of one procrastinating student." The Buddha then said, "As you can see, this is not the first time this monk has caused you delay. He also did so in past lives. People tend to develop personality traits which they carry with them over many lives. Until they learn from their mistakes and change their perceptions using wisdom and observe the suffering their mistakes cause them, they will continue to experience suffering in this life and the next. The monk who broke his leg is the same young Brahmin who hurt his eye in his past life. You monks are the same students from that past life. And I was the teacher." What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.